Welcome to the Totally Awesome Fishing Show. People, here we are again in the edit suite. I'm only in here every single night, 7 days a week. 52 weeks a year, 9 years in a row. I just don't go out fishing at all. But when I do go fishing, sometimes I even catch something. And sometimes I catch a weird species on the most bizarre method. Check this out. Well, the saga continues, people. Get my cable sorted out here for you. I couldn't catch anything. I couldn't get the takes on free lining bread because it's so glary there and the wind keeps coming up and down. So I put the waggler float on with three AAA shot, locking either side of the waggler, about this far from the bread. Piece of bread on there. Wow. Not a big fish at all. I saw a strange tail then. Didn't look. Bit of a strange fight, but I had a pull on that luncheon meat, definitely. It's a weird fight, keeps going for the bank. Tries to get up underneath the bank, this fish. What? It's only a catfish. It's only a catfish on floating crust and a waggler float. I cannot believe that. That is ridiculous. Look, it's not a big fish, I know, it's a catfish. Floating crust. That is just, that's verging on the insane, never mind the bizarre. Oh, straight in the snag. Got it out. That is a first for Graeme. A PB catfish on floating crust and a waggler float. God, what a place here at Bondwood. Anything can happen. Well, I'm hooked up again, boys. I don't know if it's a catfish or a foul hook carp. It's a weird fight. It keeps going to dig into the bank, so that's why I'm kind of curious as to what it is. It doesn't seem carpy. Just does not seem carpy. It's going, trying to go under this bank. Oh, it's only a catfish on. It's another catfish. It is, wait for this. It's another catfish on floating crust. That's just crazy. Float fish on the surface. You might ping off. A little bit bigger than the last one. And he's in. Ooh, I'm getting worn out here. Too many fish. Oh yeah, he's bigger. See him in that sunlight glancing through the trees. Another nice catfish. Let's get it back. I'll tell you what, some weird place this pond would. Catfish on the surface. I wonder, you know, is it a regular occurrence getting catfish off the surface on floating crust? Luncheon meat looks a bit sad now, doesn't it? Well, how about catfish on floating bread? On floating crust? That's a first for me. Listen, there's plenty more action where that came from. I had a really blinding day. I nearly said something to do with ball busting day, but I better not say that. I had a very good fishing session there. The film will go up later when I fancy putting up, probably 3-4 months, whenever. But listen, a lot of guys have asked us about catfish. Oh, I do some really big catfish. Well, we did, but we uploaded a really good film onto Mike's TA Outdoors, Mike being my son. It's just the two of us. Mike's down in Somerset, I'm up in Hampshire. Anyway, a lot of people ask, they said, well, we've never seen that film. I said, well, it's up there, but of course, there is a crossover between TA Fishing and TA Outdoors. It's father and son, there's only us two running it. And there we go. Shall I put it up again? So I said, Mike, why don't we put it up on our channel so all our fishermen can see a great day's father and son fishing we had catching catfish. Man, it makes me want to go fishing so badly. Mike's editing, by the way, is for his channel. Check it out.
Hold that rod. Yes, Dad. Look at the bend. Ooh. That's a good fish. Oh, it's a good fish, Dad. Guys, this is ridiculous. Look at Dad's rod. This is a monster, Dad.
I think this is a good fish, people.
Oh, man, this is a beast. What an absolute monster.
Welcome to another episode of TA Outdoors, guys, and we are here fishing. That's a bivvy, a fishing bivvy, what we call over here in the UK, basically like a pop-up fishing tent. We've got the rod set up down here, and today we're fishing for catfish. Not just any normal catfish though, these can grow to whopping sizes. We're in a small pond, so it's kind of pond fishing, very small, but the fish in here honestly are huge. Dad is down here. I'm with my dad, TA Fishing. Go and subscribe to his channel as well for weekly fishing videos. And he's just prepping the bait.
What I'm gonna be doing is mixing some ground bait. There's some bread in there, some bran, which is a horse feed. It's like a ground bait feed. And I'm gonna put some of my secret wrapped oil, which you can't purchase, guys. I make this myself. Two different species.
You like distill it yourself,
oh,
don't you?
Distill it. It stinks. It distills my nasal flaps, I can tell you. Oh, but mix all that in, because catfish, over here, we're talking about the Wells catfish. They are actually predators. Like, you know, a lot of you Americans out there know all about catfish. They'll eat pretty much anything. And that's what we're doing here. But my idea is to try and attract some small fish first. They'll be nibbling away. And hopefully this vibration from the feeding fish will draw up the catfish. And the oil could, in fact, draw the catfish as well. Going to squeeze that into some balls like this. So you can see you squeeze this into balls about the size of a golf ball. I guess that's what it is. And a lot of these fish in here will get eaten by the catfish. But in addition, bait-wise, we're going to be using, this one's called a bluey. This is a weird fish. I'm not sure if it's Australian. Some of you guys might know. But it's a very, very oily fish. I'm going to be using a midsection. I'm just thawing these ones out. So bluey is very good for catfish in the UK. Luncheon meat, I don't think I've used luncheon meat in this particular fishery, but about big chunks. They say they use up to a quarter can size.
So well, look, catfish have massive mouths,
huge
don't they?
Mouth. So that's, I've seen guys cast something out like that. But I'm going to be using that size there on a, what we call a hair rig. We'll show you later. I've got some other meat bait based stuff there.
Jax's,
yeah, so that is actually Jax's food there, as was. So it gives a bit of bonus. We've been and pinched one of his food packets. And here, those are what we call, we nicknamed them donkey chokers.
Yeah.
Because they were so big they would choke a donkey.
They're halibut pellets.
And they're halibut pellets, yeah, a fish feed pellet. And they actually feed the fish here. Occasionally in the winter, you know, these catfish go a bit dormant, they need a bit of food. They throw those in there. Once the anglers start throwing baits in, then of course there's plenty of bait going in there. But catfish are tricky creatures to catch.
Dad's been here a few days ago. He's already caught his handful of catfish. So I've turned up because I just fancy going fishing. And I haven't been fishing with you for a long time, have I?
Long time,
so
yeah.
So just doing a father-son fishing trip. So I'm sort of on first fish, as they say.
Yeah.
And then if I get one, Dad will get the next one, and then we'll just rotate like that. But hopefully we don't know if we're going to catch any yet, because the weather's pretty bad. It's quite windy. You might hear it in the microphone.
Rain.
But anyway, guys, we'll show you the rig in a bit. We're going to cast out, get the baits in the water first, and then we'll update you as and when things happen.
We don't start too early. It's 12:30.
Yeah. So here is the bluey, guys. We're going to split this into basically segments. So just chop the head off there. And we're going to have, this is the main segment that we're going to be using. And still don't throw away the head and the tail. Obviously that's still bait. Still got lots of added attraction and smell in there with the guts. The other bait we've used here is called a lamprey, which is a parasite. Again, a kind of long, thin fish. But today we're using the bluey. So I've got the hook there, just going to go through the belly section of the bluey there, making sure that hook point is protruding. Nice and easy, simple to hook, and hopefully we should get a fish on it. That's a nice bit of blood there for that attraction to get them out of the holes, and they should smell that nice and easy. So I've cast the bait out, and what we fish over here, a lot of us fish with, especially in the UK, what's called a bite alarm, which is the line runs across a wheel, and it gives it's auditable, so it gives you that audio, so you know that there's a fish running away with your bait. But as a visual aspect as well, you can use old bottle caps or anything like that. And this is called a bobbin. You can also buy them, but you can make your own. And that just sits on the line like that. And that way, if this runs out of battery, or I don't see or hear the fish, sorry, take the bait, as the fish swims away, it pulls this bobbin up and down and it moves. And that gives me the opportunity to either hear the bait, the fish taking the bait, or to know that the fish is taking the bait by seeing the bobbin move.
You come on late at night, looking for some arms to hug and hold you tight. Well, I've got two of those, strong as they can be. Still don't expect no more than good, clean fun.
Fish on within 5 minutes, 10 minutes, if that. I can't remember what we put on this, Dad.
A pellet.
Oh, he's in some sort of rut, you know. He's stuck. Go to with that rod. He's buried himself.
I suggest walking him back over the top
of the... Get a different angle, yeah? Okay. No. Hey, oh, go on, son. That's what every fisherman likes to see. This might be a good fish, you know. Yeah, oh, look at the bubbles. Look at the bubbles out there.
There's some bend on the rod.
He's good. Oh, yeah, he's pinged out. There you go. Oh, here he goes. There we go, he's out. Yeah, he's out now. Oh, nice fish. Oh, he's going to the other side. Come on, he's a good size. Yeah, it's a good one. Ready? I'm backing up.
We got him, I think. Yes.
That, guys, is the Wells catfish, and you can see it's got a pretty big head on it. Look at the size of the mouth. And nice big pec fins as well. And they can actually swim backwards with that tail. They swim backwards. Yeah. They live in little nooks and holes and sort of undercuts in the bank. They're incredibly slimy. But wow, do they fight, don't they?
And look at the size of their eye, are tiny, and they're using these barbels and feelers to find senses, and that's that smell. That's what we were saying about getting that fish oil, getting that raptor oil.
They like that fishy smell. Look at that, people.
And that was on the donkey choker pellet.
That is awesome. It's got a bit of a big battle scars on him, this one.
Yeah.
But what a fish.
Lucky
to
get him out.
Fish.
There's a lily bed there. It's only just...
Oh, is that our rod?
No, that's the camera going out of battery.
No. There is. What a fish. What an awesome fish. Right, we're gonna get this one back, guys. And then hopefully, fingers crossed, I've had them up to 35 pounds in here. Dad, you've had them over 40.
About 40, yeah.
We've had some beasts. Hopefully we get some more. What a fish. Now, guys, over here in the UK, catfish, although it's great to eat channel cats and stuff in the US, we put them back, and this fishery's rules are catch and release. So back he goes. What a leviathan that is. He's gone. Come on. It's that same sort of thing. There's obviously a snag out there, isn't there?
They might be living in the snag, because they will live in undercut areas in the bank and stuff like that. So I'm just going to slack this one right off. Yeah, it's pretty solid. Oh, definitely it was a fish take. But what I'm doing is I'm just leaving it and see if that fish might kick itself out. I'm holding the line across my fingers here, just like that, across my fingertip there. So if there's any tugs here, I can feel it, hopefully. And then I'll just walk backwards slowly and see if he'll kick out.
Oh, that rod. Yes, Dad. Look at the bend. He's going straight for the cover.
Oh, big head shakes. Big head shakes. That's a big head shake. I can say that four times, but that's a big head shake.
Big head shake generally means big fish.
That's what I figure. I'm going to move this other rod out of the way. I'm just going to dump this over here for a second, guys. Work that out later. The rod is about to explode. It's going for it.
That's a good fish. Oh, it's a good fish, Dad. Let's get a snap.
I've got no choice.
Are you locked off?
Yep. Got my clamps on the reel. Let's just see it, please.
Guys, this is ridiculous. Look at Dad's rod. This is a monster, Dad. Look at the rod. Oh, it's going to go.
Watch your face.
It's going to snap.
It'll go out like a pistol shot.
Oh, Dad, don't snap that in my face. This has taken him left, right, everywhere, hasn't it?
I'm not top of the reel at the moment.
Oh! Boy, you think this is big? You wait to see the size of the frying pan. Oh, it's a beauty, Dad.
That is a beauty.
This is what we're talking about, the rough edge of the teeth. Just here, guys, look. That is as rough as you could want there, just there.
Sorry, it's so windy. Look at that.
Very windy. And look at the hook, it's hanging there. Look, watch. It fell out in my hand. And there's my piece of reed stem from the luncheon meat. Bushcraft carp catfishing. Best part, 5 feet long.
Look at the size of this.
And they're very slippery.
Yeah, you got that end?
I've got the...
Roll in the centre.
Yes! Oh, he's so slippy. He's so slippy. There you go, look at his tail. There's the length, guys. That's awesome.
Oh my God, I thought that rod was going to explode into a million fragments. But that's mainly glass, so it's not carbon. Carbon, I couldn't play a fish that hard.
Yeah.
That's just a regular...
Fiberglass.
Mostly glass, and it really caught me.
So the bend in that rod is unbelievable.
The mouth on this is nearly as big as the mouth on my mother-in-law.
That is one look hell of
that.
A fish.
He can eat what he wants. He can eat what he wants.
Oh, Dad, that is brilliant.
Hey guys, you can see the barbels that they use here. The sensitivity for finding those baits. And although they've got those tiny eyes, they can still... locate fish, and the size of the mouth
shows they're a predator.
You can
look,
see,
at the
look at the jaws there, and you can see on the bottom all those ridges where they grip their prey. It's a beauty. Back he goes. Crack-a-doo. And
yes, Dad.
Mike's turn next. I don't care if I don't see another fish for a week.
Oh no, no, no. Oh no, what? Here it comes. Oh, it's a really dark one. They are tough. Come on, there's the, that's the, is that the pellet stead up the line, isn't it? It's their tail, there we go, he's in. It's not, it's probably the smallest of the day, but who cares? This is the darkest catfish I think I've ever caught.
It is black, isn't it? That's a
that
black
is...
catfish. It's a new species.
Look at that. Yeah, that is real black catfish. Really black. I'm amazed by that, how dark that is.
And I think that's where they get a lot of power down by their tail end there.
Yeah, that's how they swim backwards as well there. You can see it curling up.
It's like a giant, just one big fin.
Yeah.
Belly full of bait there.
And then big old head.
Big old head there.
It's awesome. We're doing well today, Dad.
It's a good day. It is a good day.
Good day of fishing. Getting back. Just to show you the kind of anatomy of this fish, guys. So they do have fins. They've got the pec fin here.
Very small, isn't it?
Which are small. The small pec fin there. Dorsal is absolutely tiny.
Zero almost.
But that's because if you look at their
back,
well,
fin,
it would be a caudal fin to a tail fin, really, wouldn't it? There.
It would be, yeah, all the way down.
But look at that. What would that? I would call that the caudal fin. And there's the sort of tail. So you can see all that power in this fish is all at the tail end. All at the tail end. They don't have much power at the front here. It's all done by the tail. And the eye, very small, but actually they can see at night. Nighttime predators. They have feet.
Whiskers under the chin.
Little whiskers, yeah. Little feelers under here as well. So you know, to sacrifice where they've lost stuff in their vision, they have in their smell and their senses, and their sound as well down here. And a big old mouth on it.
You see the ridge marks.
There's tiny,
top and bottom, you feel that roughness.
Tiny little teeth there in the top. Tiny teeth all around. Predators. These are a pretty cool predator.
Okay, so I cut a nice big chunk of luncheon meat there, but obviously if I put the hook through that when I cast, it's just going to pull out, so you need something to support that. And what I'm going to use is a piece of reed stem here and a little bit of fishing line, very thin. I've got a half hitch over it, slide that down. Okay, and then I'm going to put my baiting needle. This is a baiting needle, see the little hook in the end. I'm going to slide that right through the middle, bring it out the other end. Then take a loop of my fishing line, place it into the end of the hook, and just gently draw it right through the meat. But I only want the loose tag end to come through. You can see here, look, this piece of reed is going to come up against the base of the meat, so I don't cast it off like that.
It's like a support, isn't it?
It is a support. You see, I can tug it, it's not going to pull through. And then all I do, look, there's loads of people do different ways, this is just the way I do it. I just want about that much gap on the hook. So I've taken it around the bend of the hook a couple of times like that, and then all I'm going to do is go round in a half hitch. pull the loop tight on the bend of the hook. So in fact, it's all holding on the bend of the hook. Very often, a catfish can be really tricky. And they'll just tug the bait along the bottom like this. When you strike, the hook comes out this way, as you can see. I'm going to snip that tag end off, obviously. He comes along, he takes it, and hopefully this hook is then free. He can get hooked probably just in the scissors.
It's like a hair rig.
It's what we call a hair rig. See, it's like a hair there.
So it's not rigged onto the hook itself. No. It's not attached to the hook.
So I'm just going to snip off that surplus. Take your rubbish home with you. I'm going to put it back in there. So there is the finished bait. And fingers crossed, we'll get a take on it. Up here, you can use, depending which country you're in, check all your rules and regulations are here. This is braid.
Because they've got rough mouths.
They've got very rough mouths, and the top end of the, just on the inside of their jaw is very, very rough and grippy for when they first grab the fish. So just ordinary nylon, if it's only, say, 10-pound line, they're probably going to chafe through that, and you don't want that. So this is, I think, about 40 pounds. And I've got one small shot there, which in the UK size is called a treble A. And then I've got here a swivel. And there's my fishing line here.
And that goes to your rod.
Yeah, and that is generally 20 pounds, 15 pound minimum. Because some of the catfish in here are quite decent. I might get one over 10 pounds, even 20 pounds. So let's get this one out.
We've got two baits out already, the bluey and a bit of luncheon meat. What we're gonna do with the pellet itself, the halibut pellet, it's nice and simple. We just put some elasticated thread around the pellet itself. Here's my hook, if you can see that there. There's the hook. Just going to hook that through the elasticated thread, just underneath without trying to, without snapping it like that, being careful not to snap it. And then the hook just sits just like that there. So the pellet is nice and close to the hook, but you've got plenty of space on that hook in order to hook in order to get into the actual catfish's mouth as well. He's into the other line as well. And it's really windy now. Oh. If you can tell by the bend in that rod, people. Oh. He's going for the reeds. He's going for the reeds. Oh no, maybe it is a bigger one. Oh man, he's taking me. Look at the rod bend. I've got a pretty tight drag. He wants to go. He wants to go, man. This fish has got loads of energy. And this wind is picking up. Oh, no. I think this is a good fish, people. Oh, jeez. Oh, come on. That's not hit. Help me net it. Let's do it. Just gotta go solo. Ooh, he's a good fish. Oh my god. You can see this nice. Come on. Oh my god, it's a fish of the day. Oh my god. It's a snake. Can't get him in. Oh. Yes, get in. Oh my, look at the head on that fish.
Woo. Oh man, this is a beast. Again, just hooked. There goes the hook. Oh man, you ready for this, guys? Dad isn't here. He's gone to the toilet. He's taking ages to come back. I told him he shouldn't have gone. Look at this boost. Oh my god. Look at that, people. Look. Look at the size of this catfish. What an absolute monster. Oh, I can barely hold it. I reckon that's 30 pounds. Easy. That's a 30 pound fish. Right there. Oh man. I'm so chuffed. Woo! I'm gonna get the scales and weigh him. Oh man.
He's 39 pounds. He's 39 pounds. Look at that head. That is a massive catfish. Woo! Oh man.
Oh man. Biggest UK catfish. What a beast.
Totally awesome.
What a fish. I wish Dad had seen that. He's not going to believe me. He's not going to believe me. Only you guys on YouTube are going to believe me. Dad is not. He is not going to believe that. I bet you now. I can tell you now he's not going to believe that. Shaking. I'm actually shaking.
Well, it turns out I found Dad. He was on the lake. He was actually here. But he chose not to help me.
No, I was just... What, I walked about 10 paces around the corner there. I just thought, I'll just see if there's any carp moving there. Walked around there, heard a beep. Obviously, I looked up, saw Mike get a fish hooked up. I thought, do you know what? I'm going to leave him to handle it solo.
Let him suffer.
Solitaire on his own. Man, I tell you what, as a father, it's difficult not to want to rush up and just get scoop the fish out. But it's some sort of battle.
Oh, man, I've just posted a video to the Instagram. It was awesome. It really was. You know, I couldn't... It was a bit of a crap. I don't know if the footage has come out, guys, yet, because it's on the GoPro, and I'm on the Hero 4, so I can't review the footage until I get home. So I'm really anxious that I've actually... I really hope I've caught this footage.
Yeah.
Because without that, there's sort of no film, you know?
No, I didn't bother coming back, so I thought, he's only got the chest mount, because the big camera's died on us, no battery.
Yeah, the DSLR just here has died.
I'm just going to leave him to see what he sort himself out. Oh, what a session we've had, man.
Oh, it's been unbelievable. It's been epic. I mean, over here in the UK, I know you guys are probably thinking, God damn, that is a tiny pond. And it is. A lot of the UK, in fact... there's a multi-million pound industry in the UK which is pond fishing, especially
small
for
lakes.
For carp, what you guys consider as a pest species in the US, carp, is like a prized species over here. Yeah.
But some of these places are stocked with lots of small fish like this. Well, if you put catfish in there, they're going to eat their way through the small fish and suddenly turn into
big
fish, which is what number one son hooked up.
Yeah, I got a
big ass fish.
I did get a big one. They do, and they grow on fast, and it's fast growing, and there's a lot of them, and that's just the way the fisheries work around here. You know, at the end of the day, we're doing what we have access to do.
Yeah.
We have access to it. Everyone in the UK has access to it. It's a day ticket. Anyone can come and fish at these fisheries.
This is called Finch Farm.
The particular one we're at is called Finch Farm. Anyone can come and fish it, as long as you've got a fishing license and you pay your day ticket. And, you know, we'd love to fish some wild rivers for wild brown trout and grayling, but that's not close to us where we live. That's quite a few hours drive. Takes a lot of planning. So we've just come here. Well, luckily caught some fish.
Absolutely.
And got a good episode for you guys. And it gives you a bit of an insight into the type of fishing that we do over here. If you want to see more of this and you enjoyed this, you definitely need to go to Dad's channel, TA Fishing, which is all about
fishing.
This. In fact, Dad's put up a video, I think, last week at this fishery. So if you want to learn fishing and you want to develop your fishing skills and knowledge and watercraft, which is linked to bushcraft as well, then do go and subscribe to Dad's channel, TA Fishing, because there's weekly videos on there. There's over 600 and something videos packed.
700, I think.
Yeah, 700 now, packed full of tips.
I mean, basically, there's what it was, I just came for one day. It was howling wind. I put the film up on the TA site, fishing site. I said to Mike, do you know what? A lot of Americans, Canadians, everybody around the world, Southern Hemisphere, South Africa, I've been there, caught small catfish and stuff. They catch catfish, they eat them.
Yeah.
Here in the UK, we get what's called the Wells catfish. We don't eat them.
Yeah.
I mean, years ago, they probably ate them.
Well, generally,
on the continent, they probably do eat them, but generally they're put back as a hard-fighting sport fish, which you've seen. But a lot of you guys out there catch, cook, eat catfish. Tell us what your favourite catfish recipe is. It's like theory time.
It is.
What's going to be
way? How do you guys sort of, you know, what dishes do you use? What kind of recipes do you use for catfish? Because we don't really eat it over here.
Well, we don't at all, no.
I've heard that anything over 30 pounds is generally not as good to eat.
So
it's very
say.
Fatty.
Yes.
It can be quite fatty. But, you know, we've got plenty of chances to do catch and cook videos, guys. But there is a lot of sport fishing on offer here.
Yeah.
In the UK, and I realise that there's some people out there that will only go fishing if they can eat it. We're well aware of that, and we support that really, because we do eat fish that we catch.
Sea fish
mostly, and trout. But at the same time, you can learn a hell of a lot more by doing catch and release, because you can catch more often and you release more often, and that's how you've really developed your skills. We do like using wacky baits, and actually we've done quite a bit of catfishing in Europe as well.
Yeah.
Because My previous PB, that was my PB catfish, by the way, that one I just caught, that 39 UK. Pounder. That's my PB UK catfish. Previously, it was 35 pounds something. I'll put a link to that TA fishing video some up here. That was my previous PB. However, we have been to the famous River Ebro in Spain a couple of years ago, where they are monsters. Yeah. And I mean absolute monsters. Three or four times the size of what we're catching here. Yeah. And they, the PB, these are river catfish as well. They're huge. So the same species, Wells catfish. My PB there was 112 pounds. And what was yours?
I think it was 122.
122
and the guy
pounds.
The three of us went.
Yeah.
180 pounds. Weighed officially yeah. by the guide.
They were, and that's some fishing they've got over there. That's
what we call
next level.
A three man lift.
Yeah,
like we had to, it two was. Of us to lift it. That's yeah. a 3 man lift.
They were absolute monsters, and I had a few 80 pounders, 50 pounders,
yeah, yeah.
Big fish. But just so you guys know, you know, we've done quite a bit of catfishing, and I know that over in European countries and things that they get, you catch them on lures. You guys catch them on lures as well in the rivers, which is interesting.
And a lot of it is night fishing, hence the fact. This green mushroom,
the bivy,
which people are going, what the hell is that, man? This is called a bivy, short for bivouac. All you army guys out there are falling around hysterically laughing, saying, that's not the bivouac I had when I was serving.
Not like the bivy bags that you zip yourself up in. No, these are a bit bigger, and they've commercialised them.
It's basically a green tent for fishermen.
Yeah.
And that's what it's called. Yeah. It's a green tent. Everything in the UK we fall around laughing has to be green.
I know.
I mean, I shouldn't have called that catfish, I'm in blue.
Yeah. You've got the brown trousers.
I've got brown trousers. You had brown trousers and your catfish.
Brown trousers.
He was pulling it on the net. I was watching him pulling it away. I thought, I hope he's not swearing.
No, it was brilliant. Hope you enjoyed this episode, guys. Thanks so much.
We've enjoyed it.
We're going to stick it out probably for another hour or so, just to see. You never know. We always do this, don't we? You drag it out. You never know what you're going to catch. Yeah. That's such a fisherman thing. But we're going to stick it out. Hope you've enjoyed it. There's going to be more fishing and bushcraft coming as well. And also, don't forget, go to Dad's channel. Hit the subscribe button. Hit the bell notification as well. And we'll see you guys soon.
And listen, let us know if you want any more fishing ones like this catfish
Yeah,
one.
Yeah. Let us know if you enjoyed this, because we fish all the time. So, yeah, let us know if you enjoyed it. And take care, guys. We'll see you soon.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that action-packed adventure-filled nearly rod-busting, wasn't it? Really, really nearly rod-busting for both of us. Fantastic fishing. I enjoyed that trip with Mike. It was just an off-the-cup trip. You know, I thought, I fancy going. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the buttons. As Mike said, both channels, TA Fishing, TA Outdoors. Give us some support. If you want to support us, actually, range of merch here. You do the hoodies. Mike does all this. I don't have anything to do with it. Glasses. That looks cool. Glasses on the outside of a hoodie. I think he's going to do T-shirts. He does all this stuff. He's done it all for ages, but he's having a sort of another revamp of it. I don't do it, Mike does all that. But listen, it's here if you want to support us. I get lucky in this stuff sometimes. I quite like wearing it. I tell you, I do like the hoodies. They are warm. Honestly, I'm not doing it because, you know, he's selling them. I'm doing it because I like them. Anyway, that's what you can do. Another thing, guys. I just do the fishing all on my own now, the editing, everything like that. I need your help badly. I want to be the first old codger in British history, in British YouTube history, to meet the target, can I call it a target? A quarter of a million subscribers. I want to be the first one, because then I can just back off. I've got nothing to prove. Well, nothing to prove anyway. All the other YouTubers coming along, good luck to them. They can have it. I can feel I can ease back and probably enjoy it, because I've been pumping something over 800 films out. And I get tired. I do get tired. I'm getting older, guys. I ain't getting older. So I figure, let everybody else have them now. I want to be the first one. We are so close to get a quarter of a million subscribers. Hit that subscribe button. Share the films. Get us up there, guys. Awesome Army rules. We'll see you in the next film.